to Vive Le Rock TV, brought to you by Vive Le Rock magazine. This month we bring you Killing Joke, the original Hersham Boys, Sham 69, have a chat with Suzi Quatro and the new guys, Electric River. Plus we do a countdown of the top 5 videos this month. So stay tuned and look out for Vive Le Rock on sale now.
We're the two Daves from Sham.
And this is Vive Le Rock TV.
Yeah, and we've just done an amazing gig, although we say so ourselves, at Guildfest. To me, actually, I like Bastille Cake because that's a new one, but everybody seemed to sing along to it already. It's only come out on the set list, isn't it?
Yeah,
one
just
album
out, yeah.
Set list.
And Stockwell. I mean, I kind of like those because they're kind of new numbers, you know, so it's kind of refreshing to play something new, and especially when a crowd reacts to something new, which is most of the time they're standing around thinking, what the fuck's this, you know, to actually get a good reaction from some new numbers.
Then a divorce and then a remarriage.
Yeah. I mean, the great thing is,
and then we all get on great. Cause
it's chemistry, yeah. You know, with a band, and it's like when you suddenly get people back and it works, and you remember why it was so good the first time then. Because all of a sudden, because you anticipate things, you're on the same wavelength, on the same level, and that magic you can't. You could go through 1,000 musicians to try and replace that and get that, and you'll never find it. And that's what worked the first time, so it's great to be back.
The songs are great, and you know, like we got also a brilliant drummer as well now, we all have like still a lot in common. You know, we've got a lot of differences, but there's a lot in common. Like none of us have got tattoos.
Kind of an interim thing because everybody's saying, you know, what are you doing, put some stuff out. So it's kind of a mix of our live set at Blackpool with Rebellion last year and a couple of new numbers, but the real final new first new Sham album in a long time isn't quite here yet,
so that would, that would, it,
yeah. So that'll be coming out later, but yeah. We'll have another album in the new year, hopefully we can get the songs together and more playing, increase the amount that we're playing, you know.
My name's Jazz Coleman and you're on Vive Le Rock TV.
We're here at our Rebellion Festival, Blackpool.
Again?
Yeah, playing the second time you've done this.
It is.
Looking forward to it?
I am looking forward to it. Yeah. We had a blinding set last night. We played sort of, almost 2 hours last night. It's going to be a lot shorter tonight.
Right.
But yeah, it's so much fun. Great.
Yeah.
Because we all come in from different countries and it's great to see everybody again.
Did you play at the Fleece last night in Bristol? Or is that next week?
No, I think that's next week.
Yeah. But you're playing small venues and you're coming to play.
Yeah, we normally do warm-ups, and that's why we play in the tiny venues. Except one was cancelled next week.
Right.
One big festival here next week, yeah. But it's always nice, you know, everybody's coming from different countries. Paul from US and youth from Spain and Geordie from Czech Republic and myself from Russia, I live in Russia now.
Hell, mate, you get about, mate.
Yeah, it's funny how things pan out, yeah.
Yeah.
And so, everyone's been up to, youth just finished the Pink Floyd album, which is funny.
Right.
And I've got a job as conductor and composer for St. Petersburg State Symphony Orchestra. So,
it's that's why you're living in Russia then?
Yeah, that's the only reason why, you know.
That's fucking amazing, man.
Yeah, and as you know, I did She Had earlier in the year.
Yep.
After I did this production, I went and conducted the opening ceremony for the World Cup horse race in Dubai, and I had to conduct this orchestra within. You had headphones on and a click, and you had to conduct the orchestra within sort of it couldn't be 1 or 2 seconds out. So that was quite a nerve-wracking. Something.
Yeah.
Everything was synchronized. And,
yeah.
And I did that, and then over to Russia.
Yeah. Where are you living in Russia?
St. Petersburg.
All right, yeah. St. Petersburg. Yeah, I've just been in Russia like last year, Moscow, and it's pretty mental place.
Oh, I didn't like Moscow at all.
No, I think
I'll be going back
really.
There.
Yeah, it's a bit of a weird thing going on with Russia right now. It's very good for your mind and killing joke material.
You know all the things I like, you know. When it
good lyrics
hot,
come
when
out
it,
of
when it's hotting up, it's good for us. Yeah, I mean, it's interesting to look ahead because I'm not sure whether you're aware, but everybody in the band is interested in astrology. And, of course, we came up to this strange astrological configuration in end of September, beginning of October, called the Grand Cross. And this kind of affects all of us because it's a conjunction of Mars and Pluto, which means looks like there's going to be some international tensions. The next time it's going to come is going to be in 600 years. So it looks like something's going to flare up. Mm. And that's always good for us. We're like disaster capitalism in Kinnichoke. When everything goes to shit, it goes good for us. Yeah,
too right, man. You get some of your best albums out of all this turmoil. Mm,
not that I want it like that, but that's the way it pans out.
Yeah. So you're so busy all the time, man. What do you do when you got downtime? You know, you always...
And when's that?
Listen,
there's going to be no pension for people like us.
Yeah.
You have to keep going, then you drop dead.
Yeah. But you must be pretty damn creative. Your mind's going all the time and thinking of new stuff and enjoy it too, you know.
Yeah, I mean, we're all going to get together in Prague in about a month or so.
Right.
And do a couple of weeks there. Then we're off to Jamaica to do the new album.
Oh, wicked.
That's right. I mean, reggae music's had a big influence on Kinnichoke for our career, you know. So to finally get there, it's good fun and sounds like a laugh, doesn't it?
Yeah, good, man. Cool. And what do you think about coming to festivals like this? Punk festival celebrates sort of 30, 40 years of punk. It's quite strange.
It's weird for us because, you know, sometimes we find ourselves in metal festivals and then sometimes we find ourselves at punk festivals and then other times we find ourselves at a place where it's dance music.
Yeah.
So it's interesting what genre Killing Joke is. It's a non-genre, I guess, you know?
Yeah.
You can plonk it anywhere, and this is held up by the fact when you go into a record store, if there's any left, you don't know where to find Killing Joke, whether it's rock or pop or punk or metal, or you just don't know where to find it, and it says something about it.
Oh no, it could, and that's why you've kept going for so long, and everybody, you know, the albums, you know, always evolve, and a lot of respect for that, man. Yeah, good. You like a cup of tea, do you, before a gig?
The only vice left.
Is it? Come on, mate. Come on. Give us some dirt.
Give us some 8 dirt. 8 years since I've had a drink.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not fit, man. I'm not going to drink after this weekend, Jazz.
I like working out and fighting.
Yeah.
That is something that gets me high these things.
Take it easy. All right. I'm offended, you ever?
No, I don't mean like that. I mean for pleasure, not for anger.
Yeah. Good.
You know?
Okay, wicked. And the She Had album's coming out, or it's just come out, and it sounds like
yesterday,
you've got a good
think,
Killing Joke influence on that. You must be pretty
We're
happy.
Looking at a possible number one down there. It's cool.
Yeah, wicked.
It's good for them.
Yeah.
I mean, when I produced them, the first time around, I just opened my studio. They were the first band in my studio. And they're the last band in my studio because I did the last session at York Street and they mowed the whole studio down. And so, because it was being sold, so.
Right, wicked.
I'm Youth, Killing Joke, and you're watching Vive Le Rock.
We're here at Blackpool.
Yeah.
How are you feeling today? You ready for a good show with some? The punk
psyched.
Festival? Yeah, psyched. Yeah. I'm interrupting your lunch, my mate, so I'll get on with it. But what's all this news about Pink Floyd, mate?
That's right. I'm involved with the new Pink Floyd album, The Endless River. Probably next to Killing Joke, the greatest thing I've worked on in 35 years making music.
Yeah.
And Paul McCartney. But a great honour.
Yeah.
And an amazing experience to work with artists of that calibre.
Yeah, because you've worked with some massive ones before, though, haven't you? And U2, didn't you? Do U2 and stuff like that?
Yeah.
You know, but it doesn't get much bigger than Pink Floyd, I guess.
No.
And it's an older album, but you're bringing new instrumentation and vocals.
Yeah, it's old outtakes and stuff.
Yeah, and how's it all sounding and when's it coming out?
Sounds absolutely pristine and
It's coming out, I think, October or around then. I don't think I'm allowed to talk about it too much.
Okay, no, that's all right, that's cool.
At the moment.
But your style of music and your style of production will probably bring a real 2014 and a more, approach to it, I guess. It's pretty...
Well, I
your magic.
I mean, I don't know what I do. I just do what I do. Yeah. It's David Gilmour's... co-producer, and his vision is what my North Star is, and I'm a huge Floyd fan myself, and I ended up going to school with Guy Pratt, who ended up playing with him for 15 years. Weirdly enough, tonight I met Arturo Bassett from 999, went to the same school as me Guy.
Yeah.
And I didn't ever knew that until I bumped into him outside.
Yeah, he's a guy, he's amazing.
Nice. So, from being in my bedroom listening to Dark Side of the Moon to working with those cats is unreal. But nevertheless, I know their music, intimately. It's a real pleasure for me to work with.
And Jazz said you're going to Jamaica to work on the Killing Joke album, which is pretty cool, because that whole, the whole Jamaican dub thing has been a big part right from day one with you guys.
That's a big long-held ambition for us to do that. Yeah.
Nice little place to go to make an album.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Anyone that's from a small town around the country will know the frustrations of living in a small town and trying to build something within your hometown. There's not a very vibrant music scene in Kent, though there are some great bands. I don't know, there's just not, there doesn't seem to be the outlet for them bands, so obviously anyone that's in a serious band will travel up and down the country and play to different people.
Hi, I'm Suzi Quatro, and you are watching Vive Le Rock TV. My colleagues.
Yeah.
Sweet. Good band. Drummer was excellent. Andy is a very good friend of mine. In fact, he produced Back to the Drive album for me. We still are working together now. Andy and I were good friends. They were a good band. Made some good records. Slade, good rock band. Good friends of mine, too. I toured with them. God, who else is there? Let me think. I'm going for my stable mates now. Hot Chocolate, all on rack. Errol was a good friend of mine, still is. Smokey. I think Smokey got some of Chin Enchantment's best ballads.
Living next door to Alice.
Yeah, just great. Just great. In fact, my band played on the original demo of Living Next Door to Alice, which was New World, by the way. Who else was there? Racy? The more pop band. Arrows, they're good friends of ours. We toured with him. Cozy Powell did a tour with him. Oh, God, who else was there around in the era? Wizard. Roy Wood came on my This Is Your Life. As did Chrissy Hynde. As did Mick Chuckle, who's now passed on. As did Andy Scott.
What about from the American thing? Alice Cooper was over there, but he was having hits sort of on the same sort of. Do you know Alice?
All the Detroit people. Now you're going back to when I came to England.
Yeah.
All my Detroit friends who I grew up with and played with. We played all the same gigs. There was Alice Cooper. There was Iggy Pop, MC5, Mitch Ryder. Oh, God, so many of them. I'm trying to remember them all. Bob Seger, played with him many times.
Bob Seger's fantastic. Night Moves album and all that.
I remember watching him when I was 15, 16. We did a gig together. And he came on stage with just his guitar and sat at the piano and did his own songs. Big chance to take in Detroit, you know. And I thought, he's good. He's going to be something. He wasn't big yet.
Yeah.
And he's a little bit older than the rest of us, you know.
Mm.
Very, very good. So okay. I grew up in that era, in the Motown stroke white rock. Detroit.